strong in a few words about the cultural spaceship that the Grateful Dead became.
Woo!
That pushed all this stuff up, you know, out of the weeds, so to speak. You know, just these rad guys with their little folk music band, and they were playing the blues, and they were playing for $25 a night, and they got high together, and they smoked a lot of really good pot together, and then Acapulco Gold came, and, you know, there was something very solidifying about the cannabis ritual, and about the quality of the weed we started getting from other parts of the world, which was astounding, really. And at a certain point, the folks at the Jefferson Airplane came up with some Colombian weed, which was just like hammers to the skull. And I started to worry a little bit that maybe we, you know, that we'd gone a little bit too far. But actually, you know, variety created an even bigger swell. The bands played better than ever. And people fell into this new cultural wave by the thousands, and it just became a gigantic thing, and it's still gigantic, and continually accruing new people, and as an indoctrination, it was not a scheme, it was not a plot, it just happened. It was a natural thing, like fungal spores going out, and mushrooms are popping up everywhere after a big rainstorm. So, you know, as being, you know, personally a fungal spore myself, I'm pretty proud of everything that we did.
Yes.
And I really feel, you know, I feel a lot of, what is that? Somewhere between cooperation and sympathy with everybody that's tried to grow weed and had some failures and some, but they still got their family and everybody's working together. This cooperative nature of cannabis has to be the connector here that keeps everybody together, because that's
it. Because, you know, it's really important that we all know what each other are doing out there in the world,
yeah,
the cannabis world, which is so big and
awesome.
So varied,
awesome,
and full of odd people and interesting wrinkles,
all
and
the
new
freaking people,
strains,
like the
and
the world. That's,
you know,
true,
different growing methods, and all
true
of this stuff. It's just as complicated as some of these wonderful old farmers are.
Awesome.
And I feel like, you know, now their sons and daughters are taking over their business and their grandkids, and it's like it's really become a whole family
generations
oriented thing.
Yeah.
And but each of those things has grown as a result of that. So, you know, we had a discussion here about the worries of large industrial,
yes,
growers and hot growers coming,
yes,
in. And I'm, you know, basically we're pushing the concept that boutique growing is the way to go. There has to be appellations,
yes,
for specific regions. People have to work together and promote together and support each other in their attempts. And that's the way our local cannabis industry is not just only just going to thrive,
yes,
but it's going to create jobs for generations.